I don't know. all your prowess for.
So, and you're here to show him Jack.
Show him
Marmion, right? Or does he come to every Marmion?
Oh, he's coming here.
Yeah.
It's a definite.
For sure. Do you have to take the test?
The test is this coming Saturday.
Okay, okay.
Well, he's a definite. He will. I started the soccer program here in 94, so I was here until I retired 11 years ago.
Oh my gosh.
So they made it with
both my boys play for the year.
Oh, that's great. Nice. You can keep the tradition going. That's what you want.
He will definitely play. Yeah, he'll
soccer.
Definitely play baseball, for sure.
Okay. And then maybe basketball?
We'll see. I mean, he would like to try to be a three-sport athlete.
Yeah.
This is his first year playing basketball.
He's doing great.
Yeah, he played in second, fourth grade on the park this year.
Yeah.
This is his first year ever playing on the park.
He's got the size, too, and the presence out there. So.
What I told him, when you guys played up in St. Charles, I saw enough, you know, I said, hey, Jack, get your hand in the passing lane. I wish your whole team would be my passing lane. I said, get your hand in the passing lane. I said, nobody's going to catch you because you pick one off in the wing. Well, the next game you played Geneva, and he picked off four to put in the layups. Nobody's, he's fast.
Yeah.
Nobody's going to catch him.
Yeah, from soccer for sure.
Yeah.
Speed.
He,
yeah.
I switched him to a new soccer team this fall.
Oh, yeah.
And he was our fastest player on our team. I was the fastest player on the biggest team.
Plus, he's got the size.
Yeah,
everything, right? Well,
yeah. Oh my gosh.
You need everything known to man, right?
It's not nailed down or locked up in a pantry.
Yes, lots of calories. Yeah. So, but great to have him on the team.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, it's fun.
The reason he went out is because you guys encouraged him. Really? Yeah. Because he was going to go out in sixth grade. And they didn't know him from anybody in sixth grade. I think the first day of trials he was like 15, the second day of trials he was like the second team, the third day of trials, both of them.
Oh.
So that was the year.
Yeah.
He didn't even go out last year. Decided not to go out. And I think because of guys like classmates, you guys encouraged him to say, Jack, you should be playing.
Yeah.
So that's why he is.
That's awesome.
So
that's a great group of guys.
I think that if he stays with it, I think he could. I think he could become a role player by his sophomore year. But I mean, he's a very good soccer player. He's a very good baseball player. Started baseball practice, and he's supposed to have his first winter soccer practice tonight. But the practice was at 6:45.
Yeah. So how do you do that? You just prioritize.
He'll do the in-sport season, the sport in season, and when he's free, he'll go to practice.
Okay.
He'll practice free during the season.
What do they do?
Team is really good. They have about six of those kids come here.
Marmion.
Yeah, they come here to Marmion.
Nice.
About six of them. Do you know what kid Kavanaugh kid? linebacker for Illinois. He's a very good basketball player. He's a very, very, very good baseball player. He has both two older brothers. He's good at work. Really.
Won't hurt for college.
Oh, no, absolutely not.
Yes. I don't like seeing that.
So what's the next boot camp? They'll get there for some, but I have a meeting Thursday night that I'm running.
Yes,
that's what I did. The last home game was a Thursday night, and so we had to leave. Somehow the meeting won't go on.
If you're running a meeting, you can just cut it short.
Or start it late.
Adjourn it before we start it or something.
Well, you know, that's what I don't know. That's my sister's right.
Take
home. Do a
Zoom. Even more important, the meeting before Holy Cross. So.
Oh, yeah.
No, I'm the president of our Citizenship Paul Society.
Oh.
We help charitable ministries.
Yeah.
We help local families that are struggling with food, utilities, rent, car repairs, mortgages. We are probably the only organization that I know of anywhere that we actually go and do home visits. People call our hotline and look for assistance.
Wow.
We go two by two and we do the home visits.
Wow.
Because you're asking people personal information about their income level is, what their expenses are, what their needs are, what they want. The best place to get that information is in the confines of their own home.
Oh, yeah.
Look at what else. It's a wonderful ministry. It's one I targeted when I retired. It's great. It's absolutely wonderful. I do it together.
Possession to IC to open the second half of play. Matthew Thurston. Jacob Casino for three. Personal foul, charging in number zero, Bradley Stratton. Second personal, first team foul in the second half. Dean O'Brien at the line. is the ball charge against number 15, Kendall Fairbrass. This is the shot. Number 3, Aiden Johnson, reporting into the NBC lineup.
Thank you.
That's the end of the third quarter. We'll play the score 9-51 and the Immaculate Conception 3-5. Possession of Marmion goes in the fourth quarter of play. Full time out of Immaculate Conception.
Thank you.
will kill you. Foul charge against number 34, Dominic Cicadura, by Steven second, team fourth. Trayvon Roots at the line, and the Cubs, 2-2. And 2-4 for the Cadet family, 12 takedown in the EIC. Foul charge against number 15, Cal Kilgans. His second personal. Sixth. Time Thank you. 15. Cal State basketball. Trayvon Roots at the line. Second time out, Marmion. Thank you. End of the ball game, the final score, Miami Academy Cadets 65, IC Knights 39. Cadets will be at home again on Friday. Loyola will be here. Proper Catholic League game. Friday night, 5:30 and 7. On your way out, check your cell phones. They tell me they've got a cell phone at the table at the entrance. There is a cell phone, a cell phone at the admissions table.